Hi everyone.
Hello.
Hope you've all had a good week. We've been very busy doing lots of homeschooling. Mitch has been working very hard, but is definitely looking forward to half term, which is only a fortnight away now, which is lovely. Connor's getting on really well going into school and has actually recorded the voice for an animation for East Sussex County Council. So we're very much looking forward to hearing when that's going to be issued. Mitch has also been helping me recording my first video for the virtual choir, I Can See Clearly. For those of you who are getting involved, it's actually remarkably easy. You do have to go over seeing yourself on video, which Helen and I have had lots of practice at, and hearing your voice separately from the piano. But actually, it's really easy. So we'll very much look forward to seeing when it all comes together. I know Mark's doing an excellent job of working hard already. So let's get excited about that. It's nice to have a project to work on, isn't it? So I hope all your breathing is going well and you're remembering to practice more than I am at the moment, I'll be honest. So enjoy the rehearsal. Happy singing. And we'll look forward to seeing you next week. Have a good week, everyone. And stay safe, well, and happy. Bye.
Bye.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to this week's rehearsal. Let's start in the way that we usually do with a bit of a warm-up. Let's do some shoulder rolls. Roll your shoulders backwards and then forwards. Shrug them up to your ears and then drop them down. Shrug them again and drop them down. Give yourselves a little bit of a neck massage and then get yourself in a nice position, ready to sing with your head just nicely balanced on your shoulders, sort of not stretched up to the ceiling, but just gently floating up to the ceiling. Let's work on our mouth muscles. Let's do a bit of chewing of the toffee. One way and the other way. Give your jaw a little bit of a massage as well. And then warm your tongue up, because your tongue gets very busy with singing, and just get all the bits of that toffee from around your mouth. Really stretch it around your mouth. Okay, so we're going to get ready to sing. Let's get the brain and the mouth going and the lungs going with Chicken Tikka Mango Chutney. For those of you who haven't done this one before, it's Chicken Tikka Mango Chutney and a pint of lager. Chicken Tikka Mango Chutney and a pint of lager. Chicken Tikka Mango Chutney and a pint of lager with naan and pilau rice. And we start low and we go up the scales and we get a little bit faster as we go. Okay. Chicken tikka mango chutney and a pint of lager. Chicken tikka mango chutney and a pint of lager. Chicken tikka mango chutney and a pint of lager with naan and pilau rice. Okay, hang on a minute. So really try and work your mouth, really use those vowels really clearly, so really exaggerate them and really move your jaw in an exaggerated way as well.
Are we going up on
this? Yeah, okay. And chicken tikka mango chutney and a pint of lager. Chicken tikka mango chutney and a pint of lager. Chicken tikka mango chutney and a pint of lager with naan and pilau rice. Chicken tikka mango. Makes me feel like I need a takeaway. Not quite sure where I get any takeaway at the moment. Must be possible. And now over to Wendy for another breathing exercise.
Okay, so a new warm-up and breath control exercise. This time we're going to start off at the end of our vowel sounds with an oo, and we're going to start off lower. So we're going to start oo, oo, then a scale. Okay, now that obviously is going to take a bit more than the last exercise we've been doing. So take breaths when you need them and just build up to being trying to be able to do it in one breath. I can't promise I'm going to manage it on the video, but I'll give it my best shot. So we're starting off with ooh. So nice big deep breath. And now we're going to try it with oh. Ready? Oh, oh, oh. With our E. E, 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 E. And now our E. E. A little bit faster than that, but not too much, because we want it to be a challenge. We don't want it to be too easy, but we also want to make sure that each of the sounds is distinct. So have a go at practicing that, and then we can compare and contrast how we're finding it. Good luck.
We're all set to start working on our virtual choir performance. Thanks so much to Mark Granger and Tim and Wendy for all the hard work that they've put into getting this ready and together so that we can actually do this. I hope you had a chance to look at the Guy Bunce YouTube recording, which was one of the links on the email last week. If you have, then it will give you a good idea of what's involved. If you haven't, then take a look. It is quite helpful. So all you need two devices. You need enthusiasm to just give it a go, and we really hope you will want to get involved. The more, the merrier. Okay, there are three stages for you. The first one is to use the backing tracks for your parts, which are on the Google Drive, to rehearse until you feel confident with your part. The second part is the recording. And the third part is to upload it so that Mark can access them. The fourth part is down to Mark, which is to bring all the voices together and produce a wonderful recording, which will be us in sound and vision. So it is really very exciting. I'm really genuinely excited by the thought that we're going to have something wonderful at the end of it. It is a bit scary, because the first step after you've done your rehearsal is for you to actually record your voice all on its own. And we usually like to be hidden in the choir. But the choir part will come at the end, so when all the individual recordings are put together, any little squeaks or mistakes that you make will get completely forgotten, and you won't be able to hear them at all. It will all just be lost in the wonderful sound that we make together. So we're going to now do some practice on I Can See Clearly, which is the first song that we're going to do the virtual choir recording on. Okay, so I just want to go over those parts at the end of the verse where it's going to be a bright, bright, sunshiny day. And we'll just do them in order. So we'll do the sopranos to start with. line. I just want to sing it so that you can hear it. It's just a little bit tricky at the end. It's going to be a bright, bright, sunshiny day. It's going to be a bright, bright, sunshiny day. Let's do it with Tim. Speed we should have been doing. So let's do it one more time. Just watch for the way those notes change at the end. It's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day. Okay, and then the baritones. And you're having problems with your part, and it's just that little bit, so you should be okay. You can always pick the part that you feel most comfortable with. I don't mind about that at all, and I don't think anybody's really going to know. We're going to listen, and you can join in now with the a cappella recording of I Can See Clearly Now.
I can see clearly now, the rain has gone. I can see all obstacles in my way. Gone are the dark clouds that had me blind. It's gonna be a bright, 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 sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright, 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 sunshiny day. Think I can make it now, the pain has gone. All of the bad feelings have disappeared. Here is the rainbow I've been praying for. It's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day. Look all around, there's nothing but blue skies. Look straight ahead, nothing but blue skies. Ah, ah, clearly now, the rain has gone. I can see all obstacles in my way. Gone are the dark clouds that had me blind. It's gonna be a bright, 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 sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day.
Now we're gonna work on how sweet the sound. If you remember last week, we sang it all the way through from start to finish and then did it as a round. This week we're going to sing it all the way through in unison, and then we're going to sing Amazing Grace all in unison. And then if you remember, we can actually sing How Sweet the Sound against the Amazing Grace tune. So the third time we're going to sing in Amazing Grace and How Sweet the Sound against each other. So all together on How Sweet the Sound the first time, Amazing Grace the second time, then you can choose whether you want to sing Amazing Grace or How Sweet the Sound for the third time round. And it's going to be another of those a cappella recordings. can see clearly now is the song that we're going to do our recordings for the first virtual choir recording. Our second recording, assuming we get that far, is going to be Here Comes the Sun. So I just want to remind you of some of the parts now. So the sopranos are on the tune, which starts on B, which is Here Comes the Sun, dun-dun-dun-dun. And the rest as it goes, the tune that you know. Now, if you want to sing that tune with sopranos, that's absolutely fine. But I would like some altos and some baritones to do the other two parts. So I'm just going to give the altos a reminder of their parts. Some of it's in unison with the sopranos, and there's a couple of bits that aren't. So it starts, when the sopranos start, Here Comes the Sun, the altos start on a G, and they go like this. Here comes the sun, here comes the, sorry, that's wrong. Here comes the sun, here comes the sun, it's all right. Okay, listen again, just listen. Here comes the sun, here comes the sun, it's all right. Altos with me. Here comes the sun, here comes the sun, it's all right. Okay, and then with the little darling, the verse, you're with the sopranos on the tune. The only other bit of part for you is the sun, 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 here it comes. So the sopranos are on this, so they're on B flat. Sun, 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 here it comes. And you are on F. Sun, 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 here it comes. Sun, 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 here it comes. With me. Sun, 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 here it comes. And then you're back on the tune, and then you've just got the Here Comes the Sun part that we had at the beginning. Okay, so baritones, you start the can you play the B and the G and D? So the baritones are on D to start with. Here comes the sun, here comes the sun, it's all right. Listen again. Here comes the sun, here comes the sun, it's all right. With me. Here comes the sun, here comes the sun, it's all right. And then on the verse, you've got a bit that is a little bit higher than the tune. So you start with the tune on Little Darling, but down lower than the sopranos. So Little Darling, then listen. It's been a long, cold, lonely winter. Then it repeats, Little Darling. It seems like years since it's been here. And then you're back to that first bit that we did. Here comes the sun, here comes the sun, it's all right. And then on that sun, 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 here it comes part, you're going, sun, 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 here it comes. Sun, 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 here it comes. Okay, I know that's quite a lot that I've given you in one go, but what I suggest you do now is on Google Drive, you've got recordings for each of the parts. So just listen to your part. You can listen and listen and listen and then start singing as you feel confident. All right. So what we're going to do now, we've done an a cappella recording. So sing along to that. If you can grab onto your parts already, great. If not, just sing it karaoke style, just on the tune, and then have a practice on Google Drive.
Here comes the sun, doo-doo-doo-doo. Here comes the sun. it's all right. Little darling, it's been a long, cold, lonely winter. Little darling, it seems like years since it's been here. Here comes the sun.
Drunken Sailor another blast. The way we're going to do it this week is those riffs. So each riff, which I hope you can remember now, we're going to do twice, just in case you can't. And then we're going to go to the verse, chorus, which you can sing with me, or you can just experiment with the riffs over the verse and the chorus. Okay? Well done. So that's the end of our practice this week. We will now, so this is after Wednesday's premiere, we'll send out our instructions for doing your remote choir recording. So there's lots of details in there about how you do it. You're going to need two devices, maybe a phone and an iPad, or a laptop and an iPad. And Tim, myself, Mark Granger, who is helping us with this, can sort out or help with any of your technological issues. But feel free to have a go. If you don't feel confident, then we'll give you a bit more information about it next week. Anyway, so this is quite exciting. Wendy's already had a go and it sounded really good. And I think we're going to have something fantastic at the end of it. So, well done. Thank you for joining us and see you next time. Maybe see you on Zoom in a minute. Bye.